Nice night in Tampa, a little cool, but we'll take it compared to the rain of the last 2 days. They won the toss and deferred, and there's Mr. Excitement. 7 career kickoff returns for scores is a college football record. He took one the distance on the opening kick last week in the loss to South Carolina. The ACC title game's underway, and it's a high pooch kick. And it's fair caught at the 28-yard line by Chad Deals. And Kyle Parker, who's really grown up as the season's progressed. And he had a sensational game, actually, the first time around against Georgia Tech from their own 29-yard line. Jacoby Ford, inside handoff on the end around. He's got some blockers, but he slips on his own. Parker under center this time. The fullback on the move as C.J. Spiller gets his first carry. 2, maybe 3. That's about it.
He is an outstanding pass rusher.
They've got 2 tight ends in there, but neither one of them on him right now. 3rd and 3. There he comes, and Parker got rid of it, and it's complete. Now they go to an eye backfield with Deal in there at fullback. Spiller bounces it outside. C.J. Spiller, one man to beat. Wow. He'll be knocked out of bounds by Butler. It would have been a touchdown. First down, Tigers already in the red zone. At the Yellow Jacket 19. They give it to Spiller. And he only got about a yard. Staying home to make the tackle. Andre Ellington's going to come into the backfield. Palmer, the tight end, sets up. Play action. Parker got a man out in the flat. Jacoby Ford. End zone. Got it. Nope. They're going to say he stepped out of bounds. D.J. Spiller, the lone setback. He'll get the call. Weaves his way. Touchdown, Clemson. You talk about an impressive opening drive. Most of it was number 28. Number 6 had something to do with it as well.
Beat to Georgia. Boy, it showed on that opening drive.
Richard Jackson's extra point is up and good. Player of the year in the Atlantic Coast Conference, showing us why in the first 3.5 minutes. Tigers by a touchdown. He's doing great, cancer-free. We'll be back playing for Boston College next year. We'll talk more about that later. The kick to Orwin Smith, a yard deep. Slips
the game for Georgia Tech.
They'd like more of that to happen right here. Nesmith, late pitch. And down the sideline is Roddy Jones. And to bump him out of bounds, but it's first down, Georgia Tech. And now the pitch to Jones again for the 42-yard line. Now it's the dive inside to Dwyer, his first carry. 5 minutes into the game, the fireworks have begun already. Clemson leads, Georgia Tech driving. And here's a pitch to Marcus Wright. The 2nd in the country in 3rd down conversion, Georgia Tech. 3rd and 3. Nesmith trying to get it himself and does. They lead by 7. On a counter, Clemson played that beautifully as Anthony Allen's dumped by Daquan Bowers. Gaining a couple, losing a couple more, and then they'll rip the big one on you. Dwyer hurdles a man. Got back across the line of scrimmage, picked up a couple. Right now, they would be at the extent of their field goal range. Nesmith slips. And throws. Almost caught. And this one's longer than that. From about 47. Blair to try to get Georgia Tech on the board, and he's got it. Nice kick. Halfway through the first quarter. Clemson in front, but Georgia Tech has answered with a field goal. To the far side, trying to keep it away from C.J. Spiller. This time, they'll let him have a shot at it. From the 8. Spiller spins his way out across the 25. C.J. will get a breather here. Jamie Harper will be in the Tigers' backfield.
Play action. Parker got away from Morgan, lobbed it, complete to Harper. And Harper got five or six. Miller back in there on second down at four. Jacoby Ford in motion. And CJ has got a first down. But he hasn't gotten to him yet. First down, Clemson. Spiller avoided one man in the backfield. And he made something out of nothing. I think Kyle Parker just dropped his mouthpiece. It might have had a little mud on it by the time he got it in there. Ellington in the backfield now. And here he goes. They think he might be the next CJ Spiller, and he shows why. First down. Tigers on the move again with a 7-3 lead. 5 minutes and change, first quarter. Ellington again. About two. They were outpossessed, including that loss to their arch rivals from Athens. Play action. Parker's got all day. Runs out of time. Got it to Harper. He's going to be dropped at about the line of scrimmage, though, as they run him out of bounds. In the shotgun, Parker on third and six. Fires it, incomplete, intended for his tight end, Dwayne Allen. Richard Jackson will try a long one from 52. Yep.
They'll get some longer cleats on that plant foot.
Yeah. Had it online. Josh Nesbitt, quick throw to Demaryius Thomas with a stiff arm, but holding on for dear life. Preston Butler. Here's Nesbitt. Puts his head down, and he's close to the first down. Nesbitt keeps it himself. He almost popped out the other side. Got to the 50. The Dr. Pepper ACC Championship here in Tampa. Tech with a first down throw.
Oh, they had it.
Oh, they did have it. And here the winner goes to the FedEx Orange Bowl. Clemson's got the lead. Georgia Tech's got a third down coming up. And here goes John Dwyer. First down to the 27-yard line. Nesbitt will keep it to the 25 for...
He sends plays in one at a time with a player.
Here's a toss to Wright. And right down close to the first down inside the 20-yard line. That's the end of one. Clemson's got the lead. Georgia Tech's got the ball. And they're on the move. Dr. Pepper ACC Championship game, 15 minutes complete. As we start the second quarter at the Clemson 18-yard line. John Dwyer got the corner. Dwyer knocked out of bounds as he's close to another first down. He's already scored 17 times on the ground this year. Allen on the move. Straight up the gut, though, is Dwyer. And Nesbitt, the late pitch to Wright. Might have snuck inside the five, but that's about it. Yeah.
Technique and discipline.
Georgia Tech, third and goal. Dwyer, touchdown! Last year's ACC Player of the Year. In the end zone on the ground for the 13th time. Scott Blair's extra point inside the right uprights, and Georgia Tech has its first lead of the night. 65 yards in 12 plays, and Jonathan Dwyer capped it from 4 yards away.
You know, going from now is whenever the leg starts feeling better, I can start running and lifting, and you know, if spring balls is possible, I can play in that. If not, I'll wait till the fall and play then.
Tremendous news. Hey, you were here.
You know, with the offense being able to get the edge, on the same point, we know the defense for both teams needs to stop the run from getting outside. And I think it's important for Clemson to win first down on defense. If you can get Georgia Tech in second and long and third and long.
I think he's got it all the way. Got it in his hands. There's the left foot. The right foot's even going to scrape, but he never gave it up. He kept his hand under the football.
With different blocks.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
And
So first down, Georgia Tech at its own 45-yard line. Nesbitt gonna keep it, and he's crumbled under after a gain of about two. By John Dwyer will be on the move here. And Lyons takes it up the middle. Preston Lyons. Third and two. Same play. Same result. First down. Those A-backs are the two guys on the wing on the outside. The B-back, John Dwyer. Allen on the move, and he's going to get the pitch. Trying to get to the edge. Got a good game.
Pretty sharp all night so far.
This time it's a first man, Jonathan Dwyer. And a nice job closing the door. Completed one yet. He only completed three the first time these two teams played. Here's the toss on the pitch. Embry Peebles, another nice game. Eight different ball carriers for Georgia Tech so far. And now we got motion.
Offside. Defense. 5 yards. Still first down.
First and five now with a penalty. Dwyer spun away from one. And
nice.
Second down and two. Nesbitt wants to throw. Across the middle. It's complete, but Peebles fell down trying to find the handle with Allen and Jones on the corners. And Lyons a yard, maybe two. And again, ball was not snapped.
Prior to the snap, ball start, number 20, offense, simulating snap action. 5 yards, still second down.
At least I do. Nesbitt drops back, and flags are down. Play blown dead.
Ball start, offense, number 60, 5 yards.
On second down, Nesbitt drops back to throw again. In trouble. Got away momentarily, and then slipped, and another flag on the field. Georgia Tech, three straight penalties. Dwyer, oof, man, and he gets stood up.
And all the linebackers.
Straight drop. You almost never see it. Screen pass, flags all over the place. And a great play defensively.
This is on the center.
Offense, number 79. The penalty will be declined. Fourth down.
Scott Blair from 49. He's got it online. And he got it. Two big kicks by the junior out of Calhoun, Georgia. So Georgia Tech had a first and goal. They had to settle for a long, long field goal, but they'll take it, 13-7. They have once tonight, not the other two times. This time they will. Always dangerous. Spiller from the six. Cuts outside, makes a nice move at the 30. And run out of bounds as he crossed the 35.
Tampa's done an excellent job for us here, and we look forward to being in North Carolina, in Charlotte, a great ACC town. 14 years of finishing in the top five in the country. I'm not sure anybody will ever match that.
C.J. Spiller on second down and seven. Burnett will run him out of bounds, but he got
seats. And almost every team contributed a substantial amount to cancer research, and they all pooled that money together. I think it was up around $159,000 that the league has put together.
Second down and four. Clemson on the drive here in the last 3:45 of the second quarter. C.J. Spiller going to be spilled before he gets. Third down and two. Pitch. Spiller might be gone. Touchdown. In the locker room a few minutes ago, the game even more exciting. Uh-oh. Snap is a little wide, and now extra points. Michael Wade throws, it's intercepted. Wait a minute, coming the other way. I told you sometimes the extra point attempts can be a little bit dramatic for Clemson. That one was more drama than they were planning on. 13-13.
Looked at her.
Spencer Benton to kick. Short kick, gonna have to hustle to get to it. At about the 15, and Orwin Smith got a little bit of an alley. got across the 35, career-long field goals, and we're even at 13. Nesbitt fakes the pitch, going to go up on top, got a man out there. Dwyer was open.
They're for real.
They are. Nesbitt, late pitch. Jones lost the ball, but Nesbitt covered it. Well, that's a tough quarterback. Not that quarterbacks aren't always tough, Todd.
Most of us are.
At the 47. And Nesbitt took another big hit. And that's why there's no crying on ESPN. Nesbitt drops to throw, getting pressure, and throws this one complete. On third down and a yard. With a minute 13 remaining in the half. Dwyer's got the first and falls forward for a couple more
to be ready to go.
Josh going to throw on the run, and you don't throw many. Second down at 10. Nesbitt wants to throw back the other way and does to Hill. And Hill's down to the 33, maybe the 32-yard line.
Tight in their wheelhouse.
They're 8 out of 10 on third downs tonight. Nesbitt drives for it and gets inside the 30 top. And they will spike it. It's Dwyer, only a couple, though. They're down at 8. Georgia Tech. They'll come back the other way, and it's incomplete. Hill was the intended receiver. There was contact, and now a late flag. It
was not
a defense. Defense, number 18. The penalty is a foul. Automatic first down at the spot of the foul.
And Butler hit him for no reason.
Now Nesbitt drops on first down, and he'll throw this one away. Or will they run it? They're out of timeouts. Nesbitt throws the out. It's complete, but it's short of the first down to body, so some confusion on their side of the football, and Nesbitt clocks it with 9 seconds. This one should be easier from 28 yards out. Try to get Georgia Tech the lead again. Oh, that was close.
They blew it dead, though.
Prior to the snap, Clemson called timeout.
Scott Blair, 2 for 2 tonight. Can he make it 3 in a row from 28 yards away? This one inside the left upright. It's good. Georgia Tech is added to its advantage with just 6 seconds remaining in the half. Probably we'll just take a knee when we come back if we even get through the kickoff, but Georgia Tech's got a 3-point lead. If he gets in the open field on a kick return. There it comes. Fair catch taken at the 25.
Georgia Tech will get the ball first to start the second half. So the Clemson defense will have to go in there and make those adjustments first and foremost.
Good game through 2 quarters. 2 touchdowns by C.J. Spiller. 16-13, Georgia Tech. The battle for the Dr. Pepper ACC title at halftime as we send it to the Wendy's Halftime Report. Reese Davis and the guys, fellas.
When they played in September, where Clemson's defense really came alive and shut down the Georgia Tech offense.
Spencer Benton to kick. Second half underway. Another short kick taken at the 12 by Orwin Smith. And he got out to about the 29-yard line. So here's Josh Nesbitt and the Georgia Tech offense at its own 29-yard line. Pitch to Ronnie Jones. This is the way the first drive started. For near the 45-yard line for Georgia Tech. In the middle, that's where the sledding is. And no gain on that one, 2nd and 10. Nesbitt took a shot in the backfield. A punt from Georgia Tech. They haven't had a punt from Georgia Tech tonight. Nesbitt, well, his man was on the ground already, Embry Peoples, but this might change. Trying to draw him offside is Nesbitt. And now they go with it. Pitch. Allen's got it. Easily. Now it's Preston Lyons behind Josh Nesbitt. And he's going to get the call.
There's no pitch
guy. No, there was no pitch guy. Second down at 11 here. Now he's got a pitch man, but he's going to keep it himself.
Wow.
What a run. They've worked it down to the 26-yard line. Again, inside handoff. Nesbitt close to the first down. Nesbitt got it, and then some.
Yeah. And that makes him 10 for 14 now.
Nothing they can do about it right now. Nesbitt again, left side.
Jeez. Wow.
Rushing touchdown of the year for the quarterback of Georgia Tech.
This one here was a designed quarterback run with two lead blockers. Touchdown.
Blair's extra points is good. What an opening march for number 9 and Georgia Tech. And they extend their lead to 10. 9-12, third quarter, 23-13.
Defense. They know they're coming on the field first, and Georgia Tech goes right down the field on it.
Really short kick this time. And field it at about the 40-yard line. Well, now it's up to Kyle Parker and the player of the year of the conference to bring Clemson back. They trail by 10. Jacoby Ford in motion. C.J. Spiller trying to cut back, and Derek Morgan's not going to let him. Second down, 11. Miller follows his blockers. Run down from behind by Brad Jefferson. Parker fires complete to his tight end Palmer, and he's got a bunch of yards inside the 40 and still taking Yellow Jackets with him. Three wideouts here. C.J. Spiller trying to cut it outside. Nice job defensively by Michael Peterson to Danny Ford, who was the legend that was introduced yesterday for Clemson. Spiller, he's got it. He's gone.
What a great play. What a great play.
36 more yards for the touchdown.
They brought Jacoby Ford in motion and made it look like reverse.
And he does. The ACC Player of the Year, playing in pain. Playing because he came back for a moment like this. Three touchdowns on the night for number 28. Benton to kick. At the 5, Orwin Smith. And he got it out to the 30-yard line. Georgia Tech now from the 30-yard line. And again, Dwyer inside. Here it's cold for Tampa. But we got a red-hot game. And now Clemson's defense, another loss of 2. See if they can come up with a stop on 3rd and 10. Nesbitt lofts one. Got a man. Thomas. He's got it. He might be gone. Blair's extra point is good. 30-20. What an answer. Scott Blair's going to kick away. C.J. Spiller, can he have an answer from the 14? Spiller, whoops. C.J. got himself that time. Harper, nice run right up the middle. Puts his head down and gets the first down. Their own 37. 4 minutes remaining, third quarter. Spiller hops in a hole in the middle and got two more. College football is going to miss you. Second down and 8. They fake the toss. The throw, again the tight end. This time he won't get the first down. On 3rd down and 4. He's going to move back the other way. Parker fires, completes, and it's Jacoby Ford for the first down.
Inside right now. I guarantee you there's some there.
First and 10. Spiller. Nice job by Georgia Tech.
He's right where he wants to be with a chance to lead his team to a championship in his senior year.
They fake it to him. Parker getting pressure. Now he's going to go long on a sideline. Intercepted by Georgia Tech. Jared Tarrant coming back the other way. He might go. Now Nesbitt and company going back to work and with a 10-point lead and just run their spread option offense. Nesbitt going to throw it and throw it away.
Yeah, a little.
The exception of that incomplete pass saves Clemson a little bit of time. Nesbitt, wow, there wasn't much room to pitch there. And
you get the interception and the big return. If you go for it on fourth and don't make it, tough.
Blair from 40. Got another one. And for Kyle Parker, it's the Blair Witch Project right now. Four field goals by number 14. And it adds to the lead. Don't let number six get a head start on you because you'll never catch it. And they're going to kick it to Ford. At the 5-yard line. Jacoby bounces outside. And he's run out of bounds.
And, her family's from here. And she's the one that kind of directed me there. And well, I'll tell you, the place did not disappoint. The Suns and
play a game. Offense, 5 yards. Still first down.
No way.
I know what you're getting at.
Yeah.
And getting into the secondary, Andre Ellington with a nice game.
But a lot of game left, a whole quarter to play.
Ellington again, got the corner. Ellington knocked out of bounds, but he got almost to the 35-yard line.
And the speed of Ellington.
Might be the last play of the third quarter. Harper stood up and then swarmed under. So, Georgia Tech has the lead, heading to the fourth and final quarter. 15 minutes will determine the Atlantic Coast Conference champion. Stick around. Clemson trailing by 13. Parker pump fakes, cut, goes for it. Oh, look, Ford!
Oh, he dropped it.
Had it in his hands, third and nine, and now they really need this one. Here comes a blitz. Parker runs out of it, trying to get the first, and he won't get there. Parker in the shotgun, Jacoby Ford in motion. Clemson's got to have this one. Here they come. Parker, quick throw, and a catch by Ford on a first down.
Great catch by Ford.
And it was the game they needed. First and 10 at the 22. Whoops. C.J. Spiller will slip down, and now Parker's going to try to make something out of this, and Morgan Burnett is going to track him down. Loss of five. Palmer, the tight end, on the move on second and 15. Parker rolls that way. Going to have to hurry to get rid of it. Third and what seems like a mile right now if you're a Clemson Tiger fan. Parker steps up in the pocket. He's going to try to run for it, and he's not going to get there, but he got all but about two of it. It was a throw to Ford, and they move him back the same way.
Look out.
This one's incomplete.
Well, late flag.
Morgan Burnett's going to be called for either holding or
pass interference. Defense number one.
At the Georgia Tech 9, Spiller has three touchdowns in the ball game. He's the tailback. He'll get the call.
C.J.
to the corner. Touchdown.
You know, just when it looks like his foot is really bugging him and he doesn't have the speed or the burst or the change of direction, he makes a run like that. And he's almost like...
So two fourth down conversions, a fourth C.J. Spiller touchdown. And with 12 minutes to go, this game is very much in the balance. Who's going to win it? 33-27, Georgia Tech.
This guy here is putting on a show in his final appearance.
Kickoff to the 1 yard line to Orwin Smith. And Smith goes into a sea of orange. Georgia Tech from the 25, first down. Nesbitt, Josh Nesbitt waiting for his blockers, and he's got a first down run. Wow. Nesbitt again. Well, he might have backpedaled for a couple of yards. No, it's Clemson's. Dwyer into the secondary. McDaniel finally drags him down. Again, they go inside. And again, the clock will work under the 10. Nesbitt, whoa, to Peebles. Oh, did he get decked by McDaniel? Dwyer just grinding close. Play of the game right here. Nesbitt, I don't know. Wait a minute.
If he got it, it would only be on second effort because they stood him up.
C.J. Spiller. C.J. Spiller! Burnett trying to get him. Another unbelievable run. So far. First and goal, Clemson. This time, bottled up. Now he comes forward, and he's got it down to the 5 yard line.
And get four.
Second and goal. They fake it to him. Parker's going to throw it to him. Not quite. To the one. Third and goal. Ellington. Over the pile. Touchdown. Important extra points, and it's good. Clemson's got the lead. 14 unanswered Tiger points. 34-33.
But for the same opportunity.
Spencer Benton to kick off. Orwin Smith has to track it down at about the 2 yard line. And he's going to be buried before he can get to the 15.
It's Clemson tonight.
Nesbitt drops back to throw on first down. Over the head of Demaryius Thomas. Three receiver look for Georgia Tech. You don't see it often. Nesbitt fakes a pitch and keeps it. And he's going to be within 2 yards of a first down. Third and two. Pitch to Allen. Puts his head down, but I think he's short. We'll have to take a look at that close. The length of the football.
Well.
Nesbitt's got the first down. First and 10 for the Ramblin' Wreck. They need a field goal to lead. Nesbitt comes up throwing. John Dwyer out to the 45-yard line. Now it's Dwyer inside. Maybe three. Nesbitt, quick throw to Demaryius Thomas. Puts a stiff arm out and stretches out. And he might have the first down. Another 15 yards, maybe not even that much, and Georgia Tech would be in field goal range. Nesbitt straight up the middle. Knowing that, now they're going to work the clock. Second down and six. Nesbitt keeps. First down. Josh Nesbitt to the 30-yard line. 2 minutes to play to find out who it's going to be. Dwyer puts both hands around that football. And second down and eight, Georgia Tech at the Clemson 27-yard line. Up in the middle, driving for another first down. Jonathan Dwyer, fifth first down of the drive. Tech at the 20-yard line. Dwyer again for five more. the 13th play of the Georgia Tech drive. Dwyer to the outside. Dwyer! Touchdown! Let's see if he can work his magic from the 3-yard line.
Movement, right tackle.
Clater has battled through a bunch of injuries in this game.
Continue with the try.
Allen and Melton. The wideouts to the right, and now Melton in motion. Georgia Tech going for two, but they need a big chunk of yardage now. Nesbitt keeps it. Nesbitt has got it!
His knee down before the ball crossed the plane, because he has it in his back arm. It's not across the plane yet.
It's right on the chalk right there.
Yeah.
I think maybe he wouldn't get another chance.
The runner was short of the goal line. The
try, to overturn it. I guess in their opinion it was.
What doesn't change is Clemson still leads a touchdown, and Tech's going with a pooch kick.
Well, I would return this instead of... They fair caught that.
We're 120 away from finding out who's going to the FedEx Orange Bowl here. Clemson needs a touchdown. Parker, plenty of time now, running out of it. Flags are down as he goes down at the 41-yard line.
Almost always.
72 offense. 10 yards previous spot. Still first down.
And now Kyle Parker and company trying to answer. Parker. Fires incomplete, intended for Xavier Dye. Parker with four wideouts, sets and goes deep for CJ Spiller. Just overshot him. See if Parker tries to go to his tight end, but it is third and long. Firing in the middle and complete. And it's Xavier Dye about a yard.
They've got to get a first down.
Well, here's the ball game right here. They're going with a hurry up. Fourth and a yard. Parker for the ball game. No, he didn't get there. Guess who? Waiting to go back to the FedEx Orange Bowl is over. Between Dabo Swinney's Tigers and Paul Johnson's Ramblin' Wreck. C.J. Spiller, the player of the game with 233 yards and four touchdowns, but the defensive player of the year makes the play when he had to, Derek Morgan. And Georgia Tech is the ACC football champion.